Welcome back, everyone. Charlie Whitmack is our guest this week on Newsmaker. And if you were with us last hour, you know that Charlie, whose name may be familiar to you, is the Iowan, the only Iowan so far, I believe, Charlie, who has summited Mount Everest, correct?
Right.
Congratulations on that, a couple years late, but you know we've talked to you since then. But in the process of Everest, you really engaged the educational component. You had hundreds of kids all around the area, especially we focused, I know in some of our reports, on some West Des Moines kids at Stillwell who were, you know, keeping track of you. You were keeping track of them, working the internet, sending back messages and everything like that. You're trying to climb the tallest mountain in the world.
Yeah. Well, one of the things I struggled with as a young person was seeing that although I had physical dreams, I didn't see the academic components to those dreams. I didn't realize that the time in the classroom was absolutely fundamental in me having success on a dream like Mount Everest. So what I try to do is help these young people see that their dreams are connected to what they're doing in the classroom. I had a lot to learn about human physiology, about how these mountains form, about how the glaciers move on the mountains, about how the weather patterns form. And it was only with a real understanding of those issues that I was able to have success.
And I remember seeing a soundbite from you before you summited Everest when you were talking to the students at Stillwell, talking about kind of finding your Everest, whatever your Everest may be. Tell me a little bit about that concept.
Well, the program that we do breaks down in two semesters. The first semester was a motivational inspirational piece where we encourage the young people to identify what their dreams were. And then we work through a sort of regimen to get them to break it down and take that dream from the future, break it down into tangible components and bring it into the present, identifying some short-term and some long-term goals. Then we talk about the team that you put together, the people you surround yourself with, to people that can take you to have success. So we talk about how these positive moments building towards your dream build. But the negative moments and the bad decisions you make take away all those years of hard work very quickly. So we have to make good choices to get from where we are to where we want to be.
Well, talking about choices, let's ask you what you're going to do next. I mean, you have done all these wonderful things certainly a lot of challenges, the likes of which, I mean, you know, climbing Mount Everest is almost a cliche. I mean, in terms of that's the ultimate. So what do you do next?
Well, all the expeditions I've had really were all part of a dream that I had when I was a young person, probably about 16 years old. I worked a full-time job since I was 16, and I worked at a bicycle shop. I was running on the cross-country team and swimming on the swim team, and so with the bike, the swim, and the run, I began to become interested in triathlons. And I was reading these stories of big adventures about Everest and about the English Channel, and I began wondering if you could combine the two, if you could combine maybe an Everest climb with an English Channel swim, and then somehow get from England to Everest and combine them into one triathlon. So that's been the project I've been working on sort of secretly for the last 15 years through those three different phases of my life as first a cyclist and then as a climber and then most recently as a swimmer.
And this has kind of taken up so much of your time that I understand that you have taken a sabbatical from your real job in the world, right?
Yeah, well, I'm a practicing attorney. I'm with the Davis Brown Law Firm. And the law firm has just been incredibly supportive of this. They're very interested in some of the other civic components to this project. But that's right. Yeah, now I'm full-time working with students and preparing for this next expedition.
And we've seen some mentions in the media of what you are going to attempt, and it is triathlon in nature, but it just seems to be huge. Without going into as much detail as you want to before a big announcement perhaps within the next few weeks or so, tell us what you can about it.
Yeah, well, the physical expedition itself is what I've been talking about for so long, and that's to combine these two things, to combine a swim of the English Channel with a climb of Mount Everest and then connect the two by bicycle. So this July, we'll start in London, swimming down the River Thames, around the coast of the UK, and then across the English Channel to France. I'll then get on a bicycle in France and ride about 10,000 miles to Kathmandu, Nepal.
Between France and Mount Everest is a bit of a...
It's a good distance.
More than
11 countries. And then from Kathmandu, it's about a 450-mile run up into the Himalayas and then back to the top of Mount Everest.
And one of the exciting things is that you are going to, once again, as you did with the students in West Des Moines during your Everest climb, actually get people involved, but even more so, right?
That's right. Yeah, there's a number of projects that are going to be part of this. Okay. It's really much more than just a physical expedition, and those are the things we'll be talking more about in the weeks ahead.
All right. Charlie Whitmack, thank you very much for taking time to be with us today. We're eagerly awaiting to hear more about it. It's going to be a lot of fun.
Thanks for having me.
Charlie Whitmack, our guest on Newsmaker this week. Thank you for joining us.